Sunday morning, 30 kilometers on the watch. You're done. Your legs are cement. You started at 6 kilometers per hour, 940 miles per hour. You were blowing up by 20 kilometers per hour at 630 kilometers per hour. And you crawled the last 5 kilometers per hour at 7 kilometers per hour. You post your epic run to Strava. Big long run, check. And you think you just trained for a marathon? The truth? You just trained for survival. You just taught your body how to get slow, how to collapse, how to death march to the finish line. And then you wonder why in the race, after 32 kilometers, you die. You've just spent 3 months training for that exact feeling, how to die. The biggest fraud in marathon training is the idea of just go out and get the miles in. Junk miles, aimless, slow, exhausting running, that isn't training, it's damage. Marathon training isn't an art, it's science. And science demands precision. Today, we are throwing the romantic idea of the long run in the trash. And we are replacing it with a strict, mathematical, two-pace system. Forget 5 different heart rate zones. Forget running by feel. For the marathon, there are only 2 types of long runs that matter. And today, I'm going to show you exactly what they are, when to do them, and why anything else is just a waste of time. The why. Train, don't race. Before we get to the paces, let's clear up the biggest misconception. Distance. Do I have to run 35 or 38 kilometers to be ready? I know what you're thinking. But my old plan from the internet said 35. That is the old broken model. That model is why you hit the wall. The purpose of the long run is not to simulate the race. The purpose of the long run is to trigger maximum aerobic adaptations with the minimum possible damage. That's why we set a ceiling on duration. For fast runners, the maximum long run is 32 kilometers. For slower runners, the maximum long run is 28 kilometers. Why? Because we are here to train, not to race. Running for 3.5 or 4 hours in training puts you in such a deep catabolic breakdown state that the recovery time cancels out any benefit. You stop building and start demolishing. The quality and precision of your pace are infinitely more important than empty volume. The science of two paces, MP30 and MP15. Throw out your 5-zone watch. The only number you need to know is your marathon pace. Let's say your goal is 4 hours. Your MP is 5 minutes 41 seconds per kilometer. All your long runs will be locked onto this number. There are only 2 speeds. 1. Long run, type A, the Aerobic Builder, MP30. This is your staple long run. It's the pace that builds aerobic endurance, fat burning efficiency, and running economy without destroying you. The pace, 30 seconds slower than your marathon pace. Example, your MP is 541 kilometers per hour. This run is executed at exactly 6.11 kilometers per hour. Just so you're clear, if your goal was 330, MP 458 kilometers per hour or 8 minutes per mile, this builder run would be at 528 kilometers per hour. The distance. This is your standard long run. It ranges from 21 kilometers to 25 kilometers. When to do it. This is the long run you execute after a hard, loaded week of training. If you had a tough interval session on Wednesday, you don't want to kill your body again on Sunday. You want to give it a strong but controlled aerobic stimulus. This run is your workhorse, but this pace only builds endurance. It doesn't build quality. If you only do this, you'll just be a slow, one-paced runner. Now I'll show you the second pace, the one that makes you fast. 2. Long run. Type B, the quality indicator, MP15. This is the fast long run. This is the test. It's the workout that pushes your body very close to race day demands and raises your fitness. The pace, 15 seconds slower than your marathon pace. Example, 4 minutes goal. Your MP is 5 minutes 41 seconds per kilometer. This run is executed at exactly 556 kilometers. Again, for that 330 runner, this quality run would be at 513 kilometers per hour. The distance. These are quality runs, so they don't need to be massive. They start from 18 kilometers, 11.2 miles, and go up to 23 kilometers, 14.3 miles. When to do it? You execute this run after a lighter, easier week of training. If you didn't have hard intervals, your body is fresh and ready to absorb a higher quality stimulus. This is your investment in speed endurance. The schedule, how to combine them, the plan. Okay, we have the two paces, MP30 and MP15, and the distances. How do we put it all together? Here are the rules. The frequency of the two speeds depends on the rest of your plan. You can't do a fast long run, MP15, if your week was full of intensity. Your coach or your plan must play intelligently with these two paces. But the most important rule is about the peak of your preparation. The big, long run, one and done. You will execute one and only one peak long run. This will be your maximum distance, either 28 kilometers per 17.4 miles or 32 kilometers per 20 miles, depending on your pace. When? Exactly 4 weeks before your race day. At what pace? This will be a type A MP30 long run. The goal is distance and aerobic adaptation, not exhaustion from speed. This long run is your psychological and physical lighthouse. You do it 4 weeks out to give your body ample time to make the adaptations and then recover, taper. Every other long run, whether it's 21, 23, or 25 kilometers, simply serves this two-pace system. The summary, stop running, start calculating. Marathon training is not romantic, it's precise. Going for a run is for hobbyists. Executing a plan is for athletes. Throw these words out of your vocabulary: slow, fast, and moderate. Your vocabulary now has only two terms, MP30 and MP15. This is the system. MP30, 611 kilometers or 939 miles. The builder. For your standard Sundays, 21 to 25 kilometers after hard weeks. MP15, e.g. 556 kilometers per hour or 924 miles per hour. The indicator. For your quality Sundays, 18 to 23 kilometers after easy weeks. The peak run, 28 to 32 kilometers. Once 4 weeks out at MP30 pace, that's it. This is the science of specificity. Anything else is just junk miles that wear you down without making you better. My job as a coach is to calculate your MP and structure every week so that your Sunday long run has the right pace, for the right distance, at the right time. If you're ready to stop surviving your long runs and start executing them with precision, send me a message. Running Coach Dimitris, MSc in Sports Science.